Welcome to this hands-on lesson. In this lesson, we're going to go into AWS Secrets Manager, have a look at the console, create a secret, and then we're going to go to the command line as well and see how we can work with Secrets Manager using the CLI. So I'm on the Secrets Manager console here. Let's click on Store a New Secret. And straight away, we have a few decisions to make. So what's the secret type? Is it going to be credentials for an RDS database, document DB, a Redshift cluster, or some other type of database, or any other type of secret, like an API key and an OAuth token and so on. Now, if you do choose the RDS database, you do actually need to have a database, and we don't have one. So what we're going to do is choose other type of secret. And we're simply going to create our secret as a key value pair. So for example, maybe it's a password for our administrative account. So I'm going to put in admin, and then I'm just going to say my password. Now, as you can see, it's going to use an encryption key. And by default, it's going to use an AWS managed key. So you know that because it says AWS slash and then secrets manager. So you can choose other keys if you want to, as long as secrets manager does have the permissions to use that key. I'm going to use the default key here and click on next. Just give it a name. I'm just going to call this my credentials. You can then optionally add tags. You can edit the resource permissions, and you can choose to replicate your secret if you want to as well. We'll click on next, and this is where we have the configuration for automatic rotation. So remember, Secrets Manager does do automatic rotation, but it's only going to work out of the box for certain databases. So if I enable automatic rotation here for my custom secret, I'm going to need to choose a Lambda rotation function, and of course I don't have one. I would need to write my own Lambda code that rotates the secret. So I'm just going to disable rotation, click on next, scroll down, and we can see some sample code here for using our secret in an application, and I'm just going to choose store. And it's as simple as that. We now have our secret stored in AWS Secrets Manager. Now, if we come in here, we can see some information, the encryption key that's being used, the name. It has its own ARN. And we can retrieve the secret value if we wish to as well. So, of course, you've got to be careful who has permissions to view this information. Now, that's it for the console. What I want to do now is go to the command line, and we're going to see how we can work with the command line. Now, you'll find this file in the course downloads. Obviously, it's in the code directory. AWS Secrets Manager, and it's called Secrets Manager CLI Commands. And these are the commands that we're going to use. So I'm simply going to copy the command one by one to my clipboard. And on a command line here, I'm going to type in AWS Secrets Manager list secrets. And of course, we did create a secret before, so we can see the ARN, the name of that secret, the last change date, access date, and some more information. So let's quit out of there and go and see what the next command is. So the next command is to actually create a secret. So we're going to run AWS Secrets Manager create secret. We give it a name. It's going to be called dev db secret. And then we can give it a description and then the actual secret string. So this is the actual secret we're trying to store. So I'm going to copy all of this to my clipboard. And back on the command line, let's hit enter. And that should have created the secret for us. So now if I go back up to my previous command to list secrets, I can now see that I have two. So I have my credentials and dev db secret. Now, what if I actually want to retrieve the secret value from the command line? Well, I can do that with the secrets manager get secret value command. And again, we just need to identify the secret by ID, which is actually the name of the secret. So back in the command line, let's put that in. And it actually retrieves the secret string, and we can see it in plain text here on the screen. Another command you can use is describe secret. So let's copy this to our clipboards, paste that one in and hit enter. Now what you'll notice is this provides quite a bit of information, but it doesn't actually retrieve the secret value. So this is useful when you want to know information about the secret, but not the actual secret itself. The next command is to update the secret. So we can run this command, and what's going to happen is it's going to change the secret value that's stored. So if you needed to rotate your secret, this is a way that you could do that using the CLI. Of course, you'd be able to use the API, and there'll be a very similar option for how you can update the secret using the API that you could then put into a Lambda function code to actually perform that for you. So here we're running update secret. We give it the secret ID, the name of the secret, and then the new secret string. So I pasted that onto my screen. That has now applied the new secret. So let's run the get secret value command again. And we should now see that we have the new secret string returned. So that's it for this lesson. I just wanted to show you how to use Secrets Manager from the CLI. Of course, in many instances, you'll be using the API in code to actually work with Secrets Manager. Now, the last thing I'm going to do here is delete my secrets. The first one is the devdb secret. So I'm going to copy this command to my clipboard, paste that in, and that will be deleted. And then I'm simply going to go back and delete my credentials as well. And that's both of my secrets deleted. So I hope that was useful. I will see you in the next lesson.